British Exchange is a program here at the high school that allows seniors in the high school to exchange with comparable students in the Sir John Law School in Harpen in England. And that includes some travel, includes some homestay, and includes a lot of fun.
Always a good time. Slept in all my clothes like I didn't care. Hopped into a cab, take me anywhere. I'm in if you're down to get down tonight. It's always a good time.
Good morning and good night. I wake up at twilight.
It's gonna be alright.
Welcome you to London Heathrow, where the local time is 6:43 a.m.
Windsor Castle, seeing the changing of the guard, that should be interesting.
I'm really excited to see Bath and like the Roman baths. I've only really heard like good things.
Beyond excited to see Abbey Road and take the classic picture of the Beatles album.
It's always a good time then.
The place I'm most excited to see is the London Eye and Big Ben. Because like I've seen pictures of it, but now I get to actually see it in person.
I'm really excited to see Cambridge because I heard it's really beautiful and there's a lot to do there.
What? Hey guys, what's up? We're in Cambridge.
Change your mind. I could give a thousand.
This is King's College. This is took 8 years to build. It's got the largest fan vaulted ceiling in the world.
Make it on your own, but we don't have to grow up. We can stay forever young. Living on my sofa, drinking rum and cola underneath the rising sun. I could give a thousand reasons why, but you're going, and you know that all you have to do is stay a minute. Just stay.
I'm most excited to go to a soccer game, so I'm going to one of the Barclays games.
All you have to do is wait.
There's a lot of historical stuff there, which I'm super, super psyched to see.
Yeah.
stay forever young. Living on my sofa, drinking rum and cola underneath the rising sun. I could give a million reasons why.
I think I'm most excited to go to Camden Market because I like shopping and I like the hipsterness.
I'm really excited to explore London. There's so many things in London.
Excited to go to their school, which is like a whole different kind of, I don't know, society there.
Be reunited with my partner because it's been like 6 months since I've seen him, and it's gonna be nice to see all the other Brits when we go back there that we haven't seen in a while.
I'm most excited to see Harry Styles, the only British landmark.
If we're talking about, like,
real
other idols, Florence Welch.
Inanimate.
We had a lot of similarities and we had a lot in common, and we kept in touch beforehand, so when she came, we were able to get along really well and have a lot of fun together.
His name is James Baird. It was nice that there was a little bit of balance, like, in our personalities. Like, we weren't both the exact same type of people. We both, like, played on each other's strengths and weaknesses.
We got along very, very well. I don't think I could have been matched with a better partner. We were so compatible. I don't know how they do it so well.
We were, like, similar in, like, the ways that I thought we would be, but we got along well, and I think, like, how it worked out, like, I liked hearing about, like, things that she did that I would think, like, I would never do.
She was so sweet and kind and funny and very, like, she was so much like me. We're gonna be friends for a long time.
Lucy and I were very similar, I think. We got along very well. We had a lot of the same likings. Yeah, it was an amazing time with her.
I got really close with my partner, Alice. It was a great relationship. We had a lot of similar interests, like we both dance and we're interested in the same subjects at school, but we had a lot of different cultural differences.
My British exchange partner is the nicest person in the whole world, and I don't know why we were matched up together, because I'm consistently rude and strive to be like her.
Me and my partner were a lot alike. We were both like very loud and crazy, but we also had our differences.
Although an opposite gender, very similar. We just have some really amazing conversations.
We were pretty similar. I mean, we liked the same things, sports. He was a big rugby guy. I don't really know that I'm into rugby.
I had a really good relationship with my exchange partner. Luckily, we're like very similar personalities, so that works out really well.
It was amazing. We talk almost every day now. We really had a great relationship.
We share a lot of similarities, but we also share a lot of differences, I think, and that's what kind of works. We're not too similar that we sort of go into like clash the whole time. So I think we got quite, obviously, a pretty lucky match between us, for sure.
Me and my partner were very similar. We got along really well.
She is one of the most accepting, loving people I know. She's super smart.
Me and my partner are really similar. We're pretty close. It's nice. We're just chill guys.
My partner and I formed a really great relationship and bond, and we just had an overall really good friendship.
My partner and I think we're very similar. We get along really well. I don't think that we could have been matched better.
Me and Dan are pretty different people, I guess. But I feel with guys, that really doesn't matter. You're just gonna get along regardless.
Yeah, she was definitely really nice and kind and sweet. She liked to have fun too. I would say we were pretty similar.
We connected really well on so many different levels, and it was like amazing to meet someone from another country and get along so well.
I think we were paired very well. We found that it was almost strange how much we had in common, even though we lived in completely different countries. Don't act like you know me, like you
know me, nah. I can't do a British accent.
My British accent is quite lovely.
It's absolutely terrible.
Absolutely horrible.
It's really bad. My British accent is a 10 out of 10.
It's a bit rubbish.
I can't do a British accent.
I like to think that I have a pretty decent British accent.
I can't do one.
It's pretty terrible.
It's really bad.
It's horrible.
It's fine.
Horrible.
Really good.
Quite fine, thank you.
Absolutely terrible.
Doesn't exist. I'm not good at it.
It's actually very good. It's
terrible.
According to Abby, it's good for an American, which I'll take.
Would you like to give us a taste?
No.
Hello, governor.
Hello, my name's Hannah.
Hello, my name's Corey.
Hello, mate. Cheers.
I love it. And lovey is my favorite word.
Hello, my name is Ali.
Exchanges from England told me I was very good at it.
We were in Europe and they would always be like, oh babe, please stop.
They said it was a little too posh.
My Irish accent's better, in all honesty.
Do it. Hit us with it.
My name's Riley Tolan. What do you want me to say?
I would go up to Mr. Battersby and I would literally just like say, Mr. Battersby.
Well, my partner told me that my British accent really sucked.
My friends in England are all very good at doing American accents.
Gee whiz, it's awesome! Yes, we can! I come from deep down south!
Hey there.
Oh no, hey there! Swampy
dressed up in the finest things. I took a nap the day of coronation and I forgot to set my alarm and my partner did, so she came in to my room, knocking on my room, trying to wake me up. I woke up, I was all disoriented, and I looked at her for like a good 5 minutes, and I asked, who are you? And I legit forgot who my partner was.
For our soccer season, we had our last game, and it was really cool because the whole exchange showed up to our last game, so that was really exciting, and everyone was there cheering us on.
They took a picture with a sign that said restroom, because apparently they don't have that in England.
As soon as she got off the bus, she went to the opposite side of the car, so she went to go get into the driver's seat, and I just like could not stop laughing because I'm just not used to that.
So we were walking through London. Jesse says, whoa, that fountain. And Julia says, I'll give you £10 if you run through that fountain. And Jesse ran through the fountain for £10.
Me and my partner watched an entire TV series in one week.
We went to an Abraham Lincoln Museum, and then everyone sits down for the exchange, and then one man comes out, he puts a rock on the ground. About like 10 seconds later, he walks back on stage in character, and he did the full reenactment of the murder of Abraham Lincoln.
So my partner Liv got really sick over the trip, and she got sick while we were on our way home from DC. When we got home, she was, you know, getting a little teary and upset that she was sick, and my mom was giving her a hug, and like it felt like she was part of the family.
I actually think they shouldn't, just because no trip will ever like compare with it again.
It's literally the best experience of my life.
One of the things that I found the most is when I take students abroad to learn about the world, they learn most about themselves.
Learn lots about yourself, which is really interesting.
To expand their knowledge for a different country and see the different cultures.
It's such a good way to learn about another culture, to make new friends.
You become great friends with everyone, and it's just an experience that will be with you forever.
That really sets you up for lifetime in travel and learning all this culture.
You'll learn a lot about yourself and a lot about different culture.
It teaches you there's so much more to life than Upper Dublin School District.
You can travel with your family to other places, but to travel and get to stay with someone who's from there gives you a unique perspective of that country.
I'm realizing that their culture is so much different than ours, and I want to see it. And that makes me want to see cultures that are even more different than ours.
The fact that I can text someone every day from across the pond and we're like best friends and I've only met her for a couple of days just because of this program.
You meet so many new people. It's not about just going over to England or like having a partner for a week. It's about getting to know 21 other people at the school that you never really thought you could become friends with. Like, I didn't even know his name prior to starting the exchange.
I didn't want to know her name.
And yeah, exactly.
You have so many things from high school you'll remember. And this will definitely be one of them.
And there are so many memories that you get to take with you and pass on to your family and your children, and it's something that'll stay with you for the rest of your life.
It's really nice to see that we're all kind of similar, even though we're from different countries.
To kind of create like a lifelong friendship and relationship with someone from a completely different country.
I know I'm going to be friends with my partner for a lifetime.
It totally opens up a world that is different than just getting on a plane and jumping on a tour bus.
You are about to have the most interesting, amazing experience of your life, and just have fun.
Good luck!
I hope you have an amazing time.
And I hope that the exchange is just as fun as it is this year.
So there's an exchange motto that we want you to have,
yeah.
And that's just to live extra.
Live extra.
It's a lot of fun, and I wish you guys all the best, and hope you have a good time.
Good luck. Have a good time, take a lot of pictures, and enjoy the moments.
Have a great senior year, live life, go big or go home, do everything that you can, take advantage of everything, and just kill it.
Have a great time, have a great senior year, and remember to do your work before you leave for the exchange.
Just really cherish it and make the most of the time that you have with your partner.
Good luck, have a good, great time, don't do anything ridiculously stupid, but also just like enjoy the new culture that you can immerse in, because that's going to be so cool.
Good luck!
Have a great time! Good luck! Have fun! I can't wait to see you over there.
The queen. We're going to see the queen.
Yeah, sorry. Not won't see you.